Good evening, everyone. As you know, my name is Shimon Suri, and today my topic will be diabetes. May I begin?
Certainly.
Thank you. I am stronger than diabetes. I will be around for the cure, said that random guy down the street. Because guess what? There's never gonna be a cure, and here's why. How would you feel if you were diagnosed with a life-threatening disease that you were told was uncurable? Depressed? Furious? Well, that's what diabetics feel every single time they realize that there's not gonna be a cure. Everyone knows cancer's worse than diabetes, right? But did you know 3 times as many people die from diabetes than cancer each year? Yeah, why is it if I were to pull out a chocolate bar, nobody would say anything? Parents would never even think about buying their kids cigarettes, but would gladly buy chocolate. Mommy, mommy, I want a chocolate bar. Sam, I'm gonna go buy Jimmy a chocolate bar. See, this woman just created 30 jobs, 10 dentists, 10 doctors, and 10 weight loss clinics. Yeah, but all jokes aside, diabetes is actually a very serious topic. Do you know that 3 times as many people die from diabetes and cancer each year? Yep. And did you know that 1 little tester box is $100 and is a necessity for a diabetic? Shocking, huh? With how much money these diabetics are spending on test strips alone, why would companies want to find a cure? But now imagine if there was a cure. If scientists weren't paid these insane amounts of money. If pharmacies lost 30%+ of their profit. And if the government lost such a crucial investment. People think we're in a recession now. Find a cure to diabetes, then see the recession we hit. Now, do I hope for a cure? Of course I do. But if we think about it realistically, no. I don't think that there'll be one. According to Tom Carlier of the Toronto Star, there is zero, zilch, no proof that there'll be a cure in the next 3 years, 5 years, or even ever. I mean, when we have scientists and medics saying there might not be a cure, why should we believe that there might be one? Secondly, people don't realize how dangerous diabetes actually is. The government devotes more time and money into other terminal diseases, such as cancer, because diabetes is seen as a, well, manageable thing, which some may argue it is, but no one can always keep it under control, and that can lead to life-threatening outcomes. While everybody loves to crack about the also-funny diabetes jokes, such as, Josh has 57 cookies. He eats 50 of them. What does he have now? Spoiler alert, it's not 7 cookies. Because the real answer is diabetes. Josh has diabetes. But people need to realize that millions die from this disease every single year, and almost every diabetic has been rushed to ER for immediate treatment. A survey showed that 24% of people think diabetes is worse than cancer, 64% show vice versa, and 12% think they're equally as bad. Now, I'm not saying I want all of the research money to go to diabetes, but if the government keeps throwing it under the carpet like this, then we can say bye to that cure. My final reason is something I briefly touched on in the beginning, and that's profit in big businesses. Business is what keeps this world turning. It's what makes us motivated to work day and night for. You guys will be shocked to see how much money a diabetic spends per year at the least. Including test strips, test machines, and insulin, a diabetic spends roughly $5,000, not including any other medication, such as if they're sick or any other medical needs. I'm guessing most people here can't say, $5,000, that's nothing. I can pull that out of my pocket right now. Because truthfully, it's a lot of money. So in conclusion, I feel there won't be a cure because of lack of awareness, lack of proof, and big profit in big businesses. Now I said there won't be a cure, but there will definitely be advancements that will make diabetics' lives easier. Think about like the iPhone. Apple makes a new one every year, with the newest one being better than the predecessor. And the same thing's happening with diabetes, so thumbs up for that. And many of you might be thinking, why is there a 13-year-old lecturing me about diabetes? I don't want to know about this. But I'm not trying to lecture you here. I'm just stating facts about our society, about the world that we live in. So to end it off, I'll leave you with a thought. It's the only job where you work every minute of every day. No breaks, no vacations, or else you die. Diabetes should only be a word, not a life sentence. Let's find a cure so we all can say, once upon a time, there was diabetes.